Hello guys, welcome to our channel Aditya 11TTT. Today here we have a case of Dell laptop whose model number is Inspiron 15R, and this is the model number P28F. Okay, now we are going to see the problem of this particular laptop and try to rectify it. This is the laptop we have got right now. The battery is not present. So now what we are going to do is we are just going to plug in the adapter and see what is the situation. So that we are using here the DC supply for that. After plugging in, you can see over here that 19.5 we have set the voltage, and now we are going to switch it on and see whether on or not. So we are going to press the button over here. You can see it is taking 0.2 ampere, and but here you can see there's no display over here. And similarly, you can also see the CD writer. You can see it is not working over here, but it is taking some ampere over here. And light here is only one light glowing. We'll try to switch it off and see whether this light goes off or not. I'll try to show you the ampere also. So I'm pressing the power button right now. You can see after some time light goes on. That means on and off position is okay. Now I'm going to switch it on again and let's see what happened. It is taking 0.2 ampere, but there is no display on the screen, as well as the DVD writer also not working over here. So for this particular type of problem, we have to open the laptop and see what is the actual cause for the problem and try to rectify it. So we are going to open the laptop and let's see what takes place on this motherboard and how to rectify it. Okay friends, we have opened the laptop over here. This is the upper part of the laptop case we have opened. You can see there is a lot of dust over here. You can see it is full dusty over here. You can see over here dust and all. So what is the position after opening the laptop and see first. We'll try to switch it on and let's see if the fan rotates or not. You can see the fan is not rotating yet after opening also. So now what we are going to do is, first we are going to clean and see whether any effect take place or not. Then we will move forward with the next process. So first we are going to clean it with the brush, all the dust and all. Sometimes dust is also one of the cause for not switching on the board. So first we are going to clean it up. And check. This is a basic process. After cleaning, we'll try to switch it on again. You can see still no progress. Now we have to open the laptop full and see what is the problem. Okay friends, here the part number is LA9101P. This is a Dell motherboard which we are seeing. Now here, you know, when we power it on, there is no fan movement. It just give us slightly shaken up and just switched it off. It does not rotate full. You can see it again. I'll try to show it again. You can see motherboard is on, light is glowing over here, and it is off now. Just have a look this side and just have a look to the fan. It will give a slightly shaken up and it will not spin up. See, it slightly moved and not spinning up. So let's check the power source over here, that is a red line. There should be a voltage of 5 volt, but here you can see it is 1.8 volt. Now here you can already see this is a fan power over here. You can see over here this is a fan power over here, and that is coming from this particular VS line, 5 volt VS line. Okay, you can see fan power is being generated when the 5 volt VS line goes over here. So now we are going to find the 5 volt VS line over here. You can see this is a VS circuit over here, this is a 3 volt circuit, and this is a 5 volt circuit over here. So we have to check on QZ1 whether this 5 volt is getting transferred to this side or not. So for that, first we will be finding where is this QZ1 over here. Here you can see this is QZ1 over here. QZ1 is over here. Now we have replaced this component QZ2 because it was not passing 19 volt to QZ1 gate IC, due to which 5 volt was not drain, 5 volt was not switching to the source side, due to which it was not getting the full ampere. So we have replaced this IC. You can see over here, this is the IC which we have replaced. It was a faulty IC, and this IC is nothing but a dual N channel MOSFET. I'll show you that. You can see this is a dual N channel MOSFET over here, which is there, QZ2 B and A. Now I'll show you the ampere, and then we will move towards the display part. Previously we have seen it was taking somewhere near to 0.2 ampere, but now you can see I'm switching it on. Just have a look to the ampere side. Now it is taking 0.7 ampere, and the display is coming, the light is also glowing. You can see fan is now rotating, before it was not rotating. So I'll show you the display also. We have connected the power over here, and now we are going to switch it on over here. See, light glow, fan switching, and I'll show you the display also. It will take first time because it is taking time. Display will come. So we have to switch it off once and switch it on again. But before that, let me check whether RAM is there or not. Yes, RAM is there. I'm going to switch it on again. Now it switched off. It will switch on, and you can see the displays here. Display is coming. So this is how the problem is solved. Thanks for watching our channel Aditya 1120. Hope you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the subscribe button, comment, like and share. Thanks a lot. And we have also started with the training course. If anybody would like to join the training course, is most welcome for the inquiry. You can get the number in the description, and there is a number on the screen also. You can just make us a call, or you can ask via WhatsApp. Thanks a lot.